Sola Scriptura, everyone. This is His Word Only. Alright, so we're going to be doing something a little bit new, as I don't think anybody has done this before. You know, I kind of want to expose you guys to what we are being exposed to as gamers, and I'm not going to try to bash too much on it because I understand it, you know, I understand where it comes from, the addictions and all that, you know, as I'm a gamer myself. But today we're going to be playing Hellblade, Sanua's Sacrifice. Now, this is a gory game, violent, and this girl has schizophrenia, right? So if you have schizophrenia, or if you're schizophrenic and all that, this may be triggering. So just letting you guys know. And this definitely isn't a kid's game. So if you got kids, don't let them watch. Anyways, we're going to go over the plot here. Hold on, excuse me. Alright. Set in the late 8th century, the game starts with Sanua, a picked warrior from Orkney, arriving at the border of Helheim in a quest to save the soul of her dead lover, Dillion, from the goddess Hela. Sanua believes she suffers from a curse that causes her to hear voices of spirits, referred to as furies, in her head, the most notable of which is the narrator, the person who plays that, who is aware of the player's presence and often breaks the fourth wall by talking to them directly. She is followed by the darkness, a dark entity at the core of the curse. She carries Dillon's severe head to use it as a vessel for his soul and is guided by her memories of the stories of Druth, a former slave of the Norsemen, well-versed in their legends, now deceased, who became her friend and mentor during a year-long self-imposed exile. To enter Helheim, Sanua overcomes several tests and defeats both the fire giant Sir and the god of illusions, Velvran, but as she crossed the bridge to Helheim. Anyways, the backstory is unveiled, you know, as the game goes, and I want to bring up a scripture before we get into this. Mark 5:9. But when he saw Jesus afar off, he ran and worshipped him, and cried with a loud voice, and said, "What have I to do with thee, Jesus, thou Son of the Most High God? I adjure thee by God that thou torment me not." For he said unto him, "Come out of the man, thou unclean spirit." And he asked him, "What is thy name?" And he answered, saying, "My name is Legion, for we are many." And he besought him much that he would not send them away out of the country. Now there was nigh unto the mountains a great herd of swine feeding, and all the devils besought him, saying, "Send us into the swine, that we may enter into them." Now, as we go through this story, I want you guys to have this verse in your heads. And also, I want you guys to realize that this is what schizophrenic people are going through on a daily basis. So keep that in mind too. But anyways, let's go ahead and exit out of that. And now we're going to get into Hellblade, Sanua's Sacrifice. And we'll start a new game here. If I can, and I haven't played much of this game, so if there is any nudity or any of that sense, I'll cut it out. But I believe, as I've seen online and stuff, that there isn't. So But if there is, I'll cut it out. So don't worry. Alright, let's go ahead and start a new game. And also, I want you guys to think of this is what's going into our kids' TV screens. But I'll be quiet.
Hello. Who are you? Doesn't matter. Welcome. You're safe with me. I'll be right here, nice and close, so I can speak without alerting the others. Let me tell you about Sanua. Her story has already come to an end, but now it begins anew.
What's happening? It's breathing. Dead. It's breathing. It's breathing. He knows she's getting closer. He can feel her coming closer. She's getting closer.
They're watching. They're watching. They're watching. This is a journey deep into darkness. There'll be no more stories after this one.
What is she doing? Why is she doing this?
They're watching.
Why isn't she doing coming? She's doing this for him. She wants to rescue him.
He's already dead.
I can feel you coming.
Shh.
Coming.
Quiet.
Oh, how rude of me. I never told you of the others. You hear them too, right? They've been around ever since the tragedy. Well, that's not quite true. Some are old, some are new, but they've changed. I think the darkness changed them, just like it changed her.
Look around you. Can you see them over there?
Why isn't she looking?
Why aren't you looking?
He's in hell high.
Look, up ahead.
Alive.
You see it too.
You promised you can.
Yes. It is real after all. She's finally arrived in the land of mist and fog. The place the Northmen call Hell. What is she thinking? I can tell you. She's afraid. Wouldn't you be? You'd think she would get used to it by now after so many years. But the darkness, it just builds onto itself, growing stronger, towering over her. You might try and ignore it. There, just out of sight, where you're most vulnerable. It's like it knows that just enough light is all you need to see its suffocating power. You might think she's brave to go on this journey on her own. But it isn't bravery that drives her. Bravery only means something to those afraid of death. Sanua's fear runs far, far deeper. What is she looking at? What is she leaving behind? I know what she's thinking. I hear her thoughts. It's not too late to get into the boat and go back. No one will judge her. No one will ever know. Oh, she heard us. There's no going back.
You can't do it.
Sanua pushes away a world that conspired to cause so much suffering. There's nothing to go back to, and worse to look forward to. Why don't you join us? Maybe you too have a part to play in this story.
Look really clearly.
Focus. Do not forget my story, Sanua. Because your darkness comes from hell, and your fate lies there. They say the burning of a corpse will take you straight to Hela's gate, but gods and the living will follow this path. You must leave the Isles of Orkney across the Eastern Sea and find a road that leads north and down through deep dark valleys. After 9 nights of riding, you will follow a great river and will find a bridge covered in gold. The path to Helheim goes from there, across the river of knives. Knives across which lies the halls of hell, the place they call Helheim.
Where are you?
Real quick, just want to say a quick prayer. I know this may seem stupid to people who game and stuff like that, but when you understand the kingdom of darkness, it's pretty crazy. What doors can be opened, you know? And anyways, Lord, we thank you for what you have done for us. We just pray that you protect our minds as we learn what our kids are being exposed to, Lord. And as we learn what schizophrenic people go through on a daily basis, that we can understand a little bit on what we're dealing with. And just protect us, Lord, from all that's in this game. And Lord, just protect the people that are watching. And Lord, let them get the truth out of all this, Lord. We thank you. And let them follow the truth wherever it leads. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Alright. I probably should do that for every game, because I'm going to be getting into some pretty dark games here. So, anyways, sorry about that, guys. That's irritating. I apologize. That won't happen again.
There's no doubt about
it. He's lost.
The source of the darkness is in Helheim.
You'll never find him.
And the goddess Hela holds his soul there.
Coming.
Her dear beloved, Dillian.
What is she doing? Why is she doing this? Why doesn't she turn back? She's doing this for him. She wants to rescue him. He's already dead. He's dead. But his soul is in Helheim. His soul still lives. She needs to save his soul. She wants his soul to be at peace. She needs to lay him to rest. He's already dead. She can save him. There's nothing she can do. She's going to save him. Do you know where you are?
The bridge to Helheim. I forget its name. She forgets too. But she does remember that only the dead may cross it. That part wasn't so easy to forget. The old fool said there was a hidden path into it. Let's see, shall we?
Northmen speak of nine worlds. The world of men they call Midgard. Sky gods dwell in Asgard. The gods of earth, harvest, wind, and sea dwell in Vanaheim. The good elves dwell in Alfheim. The evil ones dwell in Svartalfheim. The mountain giants dwell in Jotunheim. The fire giants dwell in Muspelheim. Niflheim is the world of ice and darkness. Only the dead dwell in Helheim, and that is where you must travel.
You're in danger, save us. Four. Get down.
What's she waiting for?
You've got to go. Why did she do that? She shouldn't have done it. She can't go back now.
No, this is it. The hidden path.
It's not going to be. He's
Don't kill me. I'm not one of them. Don't listen. I was just hiding. I find I live longer that way. Don't listen. Never let the bastards catch me again. Never! Wait. Who are you?
It's just a memory.
Truth? Is that you?
Around you now.
For my tales of the Northmen, they call me Druth. Liar. An old fool. Druth is my truth. Hmm?
It's good to see you again. You kept your vow.
I guide you in this life and the next. I will tell you my stories of hell, if I may walk with you.
Tell me your stories again, old friend. I'm listening.
The runes seal the gates to hell. Focus your inner eye, and you too will see what's hidden in plain sight.
I can see one.
Use your eyes.
Hold it in your mind's eye. Find one like it to open the gate.
Take a closer look. It is a secret.
Is open. Go through the gate.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it.
What's behind the gate?
It'll work.
I spent 6 years enslaved in hell. But I watched the Northmen. Learned their ways.
I know you did.
You listened? When everyone else laughed. My people paid a heavy price. Carry my stories with you, and together we will make the Northmen feel our fury.
Another voice joins us. She was trying to make them go away. Pretend they weren't real. But what good is that? When we are.
Is ruled by the giantess, Hela, daughter of Loki. The gods feared her bloodline, bad on her mother's side, and yet much worse on her father's. So, as a child, the Allfather cast her down into Helheim and gave her power over those who die of sickness, age, hardship, and self-slaughter. In all of the 9 worlds, only Hela can resurrect the dead. To Hela, your Dillion was sacrificed. And with her, you must bargain.
The gate.
the living from the dead. Is that the face of Hela herself? The half-rotten goddess that rules over Helheim. Whatever horrors lie behind that door, she must find him. Does not bargain. It does not reason. It is rot. And now it has taken hold. It will spread towards her head, the seat of the soul, until there is nothing left of her. All of her suffering will have been for nothing. It's just a matter of time.
Yeah,
hardest battles are fought in the mind. That is what Dillian taught her. With every defeat, the dark rot will grow and soon it will take her soul. But for now, at least, she still has control of her mind. And she will fulfill her vow, whatever the cost.
He's not right.
Listen to me, Sanua. The goddess Hela lies behind the gate to Helheim. To open the gate, you must first face the gods that guard it. The god of fire, Surt, and the god of illusion, Valravn. Spill their blood to open the gate to Helheim and enter the land of the dead.
To Dillian.
To his soul. It won't open.
How will she get through?
Why won't it open?
Why can't she? She needs to challenge the gods.
She has to fight two gods first.
Two gods?
Two gates.
Valravn, ancestor of the seers and master of ravens. He hunts his prey with his powers of illusion and feasts on their remains. Follow the path to Valravn and defeat him in battle to earn his mark. The gate to Helheim cannot be opened without it. Illusion hides the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes. Find another way to see the truth.
What's that? It's a wall. It's a door.
No.
Behind the veil, don't we? Once we do, we mostly just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there.
Thank you.
God she tried. Begged.
Valravn's power of illusion comes from ravens, allowing the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Truth.
Look how much has changed.
break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravan.
Another gate.
You know what to do. Stay back. You have to open it.
It's not safe. Don't listen to them. Listen. Don't open it.
You can do it.
Don't touch it. Stay back. Come on.
To break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravan.
Where are they? Do it.
Where are they?
What does it mean? Line up the ravens.
Which ravens?
Where are they?
Can't you see them, she calls?
Look around. Try to find the ravens.
Line up the ravens.
Line them up.
Thank you.
going to stop it there. But the next episode, we'll get into whoever that guy is. Probably watch me get my butt kicked. But you guys see why I chose this? It's got everything in it, man. It has gods, the Nephilim, right? Niflheim. I mean, if that ain't a tell, then I don't know what is. The giants. It has all this stuff. And I want you, Christians especially, to really, because, like, it's crazy. You know, Christians are supposed to be the leading in the supernatural, right? But yet, I could talk about the Nephilim and giants and aliens and all that stuff more with a pagan than I can a Christian. And it's in our Bibles. If you haven't seen my stuff, you know, it's in all my videos. But I hope you guys get something out of this. And I also want you guys to see what our minds are being exposed to. And, you know, games are a big reason why people are moving to the occult. And would be nice, I mean, you can make some epic video games, you know, with the stories in the Bible. But of course, you ain't gonna see it. This is what you're gonna get. These are, trust me, great games, fun games, you know, and if you play games, you know, I'm not gonna bash you. I'm not gonna sit here and judge you. Cause I ain't perfect either. I play video games, you know? And if you're just coming here for the video games and not the religious stuff, you know, that's fine, you know. But just realize this is a religious channel. But you will get some off-the-wall stuff. It seems off-the-wall until you look into it for yourself. And the whole point is to get you to look into this stuff yourself. There's a reason why all the societies, ancient societies around the world, by the way, around the world, have giants, satyrs, all this stuff around the world, not just the Greek mythology, all around the world. And it comes from somewhere. They're not just seeing this, you know, especially if all cultures around the world are seeing it. And most cultures around the world have a flood story that is synonymous with giants. And then we got to ask ourselves, well, why are these gods always depicted as giant? But anyways, you guys have a wonderful night. And I hope you guys do enjoy this series. And the series will get better and better as it gets going. Alright, you guys have a wonderful night.